Hello. 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 Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me once again. And I hope you're all doing well. Well, it's time for another ASMR experience. Imagine you dream of zombies coming towards your house like you're being invaded by zombies. My very first ASMR video was me sharing a dream where I had zombies coming toward my house. In this video, I will make you imagine through my perspective this dream of zombies coming towards your house. My house, but for you in your perspective, as if you're the one dreaming, with a little twist. So, let's get started. You are a teenager. You live in a two-story house. It is a cool summer night. And you have just finished playing Call of Duty Black Ops 2 Zombies. You played a map called Transit, and basically you survive zombies while going through different places using a bus. But let's get this out of the way. And you just finished playing that game. And it's a summer night, you have no school, and you are on summer break. You start at your bedroom upstairs. You happen to enjoy a cup of green tea, and you seem to enjoy it. It's pretty soothing, okay. As you are halfway into your sipping, you happen to glance outside your bedroom window. You look over there, and off at the distance, you see your backyard, and you see two glowing blue eyes. You look closer to examine what that thing is, what you're really seeing, and you see like a person that looks pretty drunk that's coming towards you, and you do not recognize that figure, and you realize that it is a zombie. You quickly realize that zombie is slowly coming towards your house. You start to feel a bit shocked as you see a zombie coming towards you. And you quickly realize that the zombie is not alone. You realize that you're being invaded by zombies like an apocalypse. This is round one. Keep in mind, a bit of layout. Your house is a two-story house. You have your ground floor, which has a living room, your kitchen, and the dining table. A bathroom that has no shower. It's called a powder room. And of course, your front door. Upstairs is your bedroom, your parents' bedroom, your bathroom, another bathroom, and a spare room. Outside is your backyard with a shed, with your bedroom window faces it, so you could see the backyard. So as you are at your bedroom and seeing a few zombies outside your window, you quickly react. do not have a gun, so there's no guns in this story. While Call of Duty has guns, this story will have no guns. So that's just another hint. You have no gun, but you have a few straws. You use those few straws to throw them outside the window. Somehow those straws are enough to eliminate the zombies. After killing those zombies, you feel relieved. And you see no more zombies. So you feel relieved that this is all over. It's time to rest. So you feel relieved until 2 minutes later. You hear more noises. You hear more noises coming in the backyard. There's some mouse clicking sounds. And of course those straws. I'm going to be using these straws for a big chunk of this experience. So this is round two, okay. If you know Call of Duty zombies, you see how zombies come in different rounds. You have to survive by fending off zombies, and they come in rounds. Like, you start at round one, and after you beat round two, there is round two. But the zombies get harder and harder to beat as the rounds progress, and it gets harder every time you finish a round. And you just have to survive and try to get as high as you can. Okay, I'm just rubbing these straws, okay. Okay, so this is what you are experiencing. These zombies come in waves, much like Call of Duty zombies come in rounds. You look outside and you see more zombies. Again, you use these straws to defend against those zombies. So you take care of these zombies. They still seem very easy to kill. These straws are working, okay? You start to hear them coming closer, and you manage to beat them from your bedroom. But, however, as you are busy getting those zombies done over, you start to hear sounds coming from your upstairs bedroom and your upstairs. Bathroom. It's coming from the bathroom, okay? So it's opposite to your room. So it's on the other side of your house. This bathroom window is facing the front porch. And so you go out to the bathroom, and you see zombies as well coming from the front porch. So again, use these straws to fend them off, okay? You use these straws to somehow kill them. So eventually, after taking care of those zombies from your bedroom and from the washroom, everything seems to be silent. You don't see any more zombies that are alive. So you cross your fingers and you cross your straws, and hopefully this is all over. And that's what you think in your mind, okay? But unfortunately, that is not the case. As you hear sounds again, okay? This is a hairspray. No, not hairspray. I don't know why you call it a hairspray. This is a perfume. And it has a good smell, so I got it before. So I'm going to use this for more tingles. So there, you hear more sounds. And you are now at round three. This is round three, okay? Round three. You look outside and you see a lot more zombies coming towards your house from your backyard. It's popping out from the trees and are coming out in all directions of your backyard. You still have your straws and you start throwing them once again. Apparently, this time you realize that these straws are taking more time to kill those zombies. Apparently, they are taking more hits to kill each zombie. Again, you hear noises from the bathroom. You happen to go to the washroom, and you happen to see more zombies coming from the front porch. You kill them with these straws, and you realized they're harder to kill, as they require more hits compared to the other rounds that happened earlier, okay? So, after killing a dozen or so zombies, and trying your best to use your straws, you see no more zombies once again. You feel more relieved. You feel more relieved again that this round is ended. But it's only temporary, because shortly after a few more minutes, you hear more noises. You hear more noises, and a lot more noises. So, this is it. Round four happens. You look out your bedroom window, and you see many, many zombies, like 20 or so, like quite a lot. You try to use your straws, and they seem to be not as useful. You manage to kill one, but that took many, many, many straws. You realize that you're running out of straws, and before you think of an alternative option, you happen to use your remaining straws to kill a few more zombies. So you had like a few more straws. You don't know how many, but just because you quickly run out of them, okay? And now you need to find out an alternative, okay? And your alternative is your teaspoon, the teaspoon that you use after you drank your tea. It is getting pretty hot in my room. I do not know why it is hot in my room, but yeah, I have to blow to kind of flap my t-shirt. And yeah, look at this picture. It's Beetlejuice. It's pretty cool. It's like an old movie. So yeah, you get your teaspoon. That's your alternative. Okay, your teaspoon. You grab it, and you look outside. You look outside your window, and you realize you see a zombie. One of the zombies is climbing towards your bedroom window. Just to recap, you are at the second floor of your house, like upstairs. So you use a teaspoon and hit the head of the zombie that's climbing towards your windowsill, which seems to work much more efficiently than these straws. And then you managed to kill that zombie pretty easily, faster. And what's happening is that you hear banging at the other windows, the bathroom and the guest room, and you realize that they're also climbing from those and climb into those windows. You repeat the process of using your teaspoon to fend off the zombies, and then you eventually beat them all. after this round. After sinking down what just happened, you feel really uneasy and you try to find something else to defend against the zombies. Forks can also work, but there are downstairs. So you just stay upstairs because you are scared that you get paranoid that there is a zombie inside your house still. Inside, especially if you have not checked downstairs, okay. Alright. You have no gun, only a teaspoon. You hear sounds again, signifying that round 5 has begun. So round 5, okay. This is round 5. Round 5. The windows that you have are all broken. And you start to see zombies start running. Zombies are now running towards your place. It's another teaspoon. Okay, they are breaking all of these windows, and the windows become broken, and the zombies are becoming more aggressive. You use your teaspoon to fend off those zombies through climbing through the windows. At this point, the zombies are getting much smarter than before. They climb faster, they run quicker, and they can come in from any direction. Your teaspoon starts to take more hits, and they're starting to resist your hits. You struggle to fend them off, and you have to juggle between the zombies coming from your bedroom window, then the bathroom window, then the guest bedroom. They're all coming from those windows. At one point, you hear footsteps coming from the stairs. You realize that the zombies are coming from the ground floor as they made your way into your house, inside your house as well. You go to the stairs, and a zombie is coming up the stairs. You actually see the zombie coming up the stairs. You manage to use your spoon to kill it. Surprisingly, you hear no more sounds, and there are no more zombies. So, you look outside. And to make sure that there are no zombies alive. But something changed. You see fog. You see fog. Fog. Okay. Round 6 is here. Round 6. And it's suddenly foggy outside. For some reason, it is so foggy that you can only see up to 3 feet away. So you cannot even see the grass in your backyard. That's how foggy it got. You tried to go to your parents in the master bedroom. You do not know why you have not got to your parents' bedroom before, but you decide to go this time. They are sound asleep. You then try to close down all the blinds, your bedroom, then the washroom, and then the guest bedroom, And then you double check the master bedroom, and you find that the window is intact, and the blinds are already closed. You then prepare for the zombies to come. You look at your hand, and you realize your teaspoon is broken. Like your tea, the spoon part has cut off. So, at that moment where the fog happens is where your dream has ended and you wake up. So you don't know what happens in this round, but you just, your dream just ends and wakes up, and you wake up. So that's the end of that dream. So, I hope you enjoyed this imagination experience, and I wanted to share you a dream of a zombie invasion through my perspective with ASMR triggers. So, keep in mind that many parts of my original dream have been changed to give you more imagination. I made up some of the parts of the dream so that you will experience more imagination. So, just because my original dream with zombies was pretty uneventful, but if you want to see my oldest video, the original video is also in the link. So, if you're new to this channel, I make ASMR-fied videos like this one. I make coding videos as well as some other formatted videos covering different topics like the backrooms as well as other facts of space of any subject. But yeah, I'm seeing that you guys are enjoying this kind of trend, and if this video hits 20 likes, I'm gonna make another video like this one. And so, stay tuned for the next video, and I'll see you next time.